What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. The Input Kludge Anti-Pattern, also known as ad hoc input processing, arises when a software system lacks clear and consistent handling of user inputs, leading to reduced reliability of the system and impaired user experience. To further understand how this anti-pattern might arise, consider a scenario where a software development team is tasked with building an e-commerce platform. During the initial stages of development, they create a feature that allows users to search for products by entering keywords into a search bar. However, due to time constraints and pressure to deliver results quickly, the team implements a quick and simple search algorithm that scans through the entire database every time a search query is entered. As the platform gains popularity and the volume of products in the database grows, users start experiencing significant delays when performing searches. The search functionality, which was initially designed as a temporary solution to meet immediate needs, now struggles to handle the increasing load efficiently. Upon investigation, the team realizes that the input handling mechanism for search queries was hastily implemented without considering scalability or optimization. This approach, known as the input kludge, has led to performance issues, user dissatisfaction, and the need for extensive refactoring to improve the search functionality. The solution implemented becomes inadequate as the system scales and evolves. Let's consider another scenario in which a software development team is building a web form for user registration on a website. The form includes fields for the user's name, email address, password, and date of birth. Due to time constraints and the urgency to launch the website quickly, the development team implements basic input validation for the form field that only checks for the presence of data. As a result, users are able to submit incomplete or incorrectly formatted data without receiving appropriate error messages. Over time, users encounter issues such as account creation failures, password reset difficulties, and data inconsistencies in the system. In this example, the input kludge manifested as a hastily implemented input validation mechanism that fails to adequately enforce data integrity and user input requirements. Now, let's break down the signs or symptoms of this anti-pattern using the examples we just gave. So, this anti-pattern could manifest in inconsistent handling of user inputs across different parts of the system, unpredictable behavior or errors occurring due to unexpected user inputs, the lack of validation or sanitization of user inputs leading to security vulnerabilities, and the difficulty in maintaining and extending the system due to tangled input processing logic. The input kludge anti-pattern is mainly caused by the lack of clear requirements or specifications regarding input handling, an ad hoc implementation for input validation or processing, an inadequate understanding of potential input variations and edge cases, and a tight coupling between input processing logic and other system components. Now, everything we just mentioned contributes to a reduced reliability in the system and a lack of stability due to unforeseen input-related errors. Additionally, it increases the vulnerability to security threats such as injection attacks, a higher maintenance overhead since developers will struggle to debug and fix input-related issues, also, and more importantly, an impaired user experience and satisfaction due to inconsistent or confusing input behavior. To combat this anti-pattern, we must clearly define and document input requirements, including acceptable formats, ranges, and constraints. We must implement a robust input validation mechanism to ensure that only valid inputs are processed. Another important point is to centralize input processing logic to promote consistency and maintainability, and to use defensive programming techniques to handle unexpected input gracefully, such as input sanitization and error handling. Finally, the team needs to regularly review and update input handling mechanisms to adapt to evolving requirements and mitigate emergency security risks. So, to sum up, the input kludge anti-pattern emerges from a lack of standardized input validation protocols, leading to ad hoc implementation and potential performance issues. By establishing robust validation mechanisms and standardizing input handling procedures, development teams can mitigate the risks associated with this anti-pattern and ensure a more reliable software. Failure to address the input kludge may result in additional and insufficient code maintenance and increased susceptibility to security vulnerabilities. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.